So now we'll discuss about the concave lens, right? Okay, so here is concave lens. Right? Now this is the optical center, the center part, and this is the principal axis y and x. So we have studied about the convex lens a bit, and after this we are definitely going to talk about how image formation takes place in the convex lens, and the after that then the concave lens. So for now we have seen like how, you know, the different parts we have studied in the convex lens, like where was the optical center, then where was the, you know, focus f f dash, then also 2f and all. So now this here we are talking about the concave lens. Now so this is C, or it can be also represented as O. Now again I am not talking about the definitions, because now we know like the center of the middle part of the center part of the lens is known as the optical center. So this is the center part. Now a line which passes through the center of, you know, optical center, a line which passes through the optical center is known as principal axis. So this one is what? Principal axis. Now how to find out the focus and where the focus will be. So if the rays which are parallel, right, the rays which are parallel to the principal axis, right, the ray which is parallel to the principal axis, it gets scattered, okay, it gets scattered when it passes through the lens and after refraction, right. Here also the ray which is parallel to the principal axis will get scattered after refraction. I am making one more, so this is also getting refracted. After refraction this is all going out, it is getting scattered. So we know this, this is a diverging lens, right, we know like this is a diverging lens, so it is getting diverged. But we have studied now in the mirrors like what will happen if we, now this is the, this is our other rays, principal axis, again I'll make it little darker with this other color so that one can understand, like this is a principal axis, this is my optical center. Now after refraction it is getting scattered because it is a diverging lens. Now when we try to merge, we try to extend these rays at one point, so again these all are meeting at one point, right, and this is known as our focus, right, this is known as our focus. Now again as these rays are not intersecting in really, you know, in reality they are not meeting actually, they are just appearing, we are trying, you know, they are, we have extended these rays. So concave lens always have virtual focus. It has what kind of focus? It has virtual focus. Whereas convex lens, right, the convex lens had convex lens, what we should say, like it always has real focus, whereas the and this one is converging. So convex lenses are converging lenses and they have real focus because the line, the rays, I should say the rays, they meet, they intersect really, right. Now concave lens is a diverging lens because actually the rays are not intersecting with each other, they are meeting, you know, they are intersecting after the refraction, no, they are not intersecting, they are not meeting after refraction, they are getting scattered, right, these are going in this way, these are going in this way. But when we try to meet it, when we extend it backwards, so we get one point where all these rays, you know, they come and meet, and so this can be known as the focus, right. Now again this side also will have the focus. Now this here we have passed the rays from this side, definitely when the rays will be passed from this side, so again, you know, as I have explained in convex also, so here also we'll have got two focus, we'll have two focus, then the 2f will be there, here also we'll have 2f. Now what is aperture? Aperture is lift. Now aperture is, what is aperture? That particular surface, that particular surface from where the refraction takes place. So refracting surface. Total refracting surface, or in easy word, if I want to say, no, aperture is that particular part of the lens from where the refraction is taking place. So these all are the points which we need to understand in concave lenses also. It becomes more easy to understand because now we have already done with the convex lens. Now what we'll talk about, now we'll discuss the rules of convex lens. Right, rules of what, children? Image formation. So I have written in short, rules of image formation will be seen in the convex lens. Now mainly three rules we will be discussing about. Right, so this is the lens, I am talking about the convex lens. This is optical center, this is the principal axis, right, this is x, this is y, this is c. Right, now when a ray of light which comes parallelly, okay, which comes parallelly to this surface after refraction, okay, after refraction in the lens, it goes refraction in the lens only, it get bends and it meet at one point which is known as focus. Right, so again the same thing, that when a parallel ray of light passes, name it, say A, you know, this A, the ray, AB ray is parallel to this principal axis which passes from the lens, and at the point D it gets refracted and it meets at one point and it passes from the focus. So this is the first rule, as we have discussed always, that when the ray of light which is, you know, parallel to the principal axis, it will pass through the focus, and when the ray of light comes from the focus, just it will become parallel to the principal axis. Now we will talk about the second rule. Now see, and now I am not discussing in detail because this we all have understood in the mirrors also. And one more very important thing, you might be thinking like, why I am discussing this all in 8th standard, because you know we have to study the structure of eye. For understanding the structure of eye, like when I say like eye has got convex lens, so what is the meaning of convex lens, you won't be able to understand. That is the reason, you know, I am not teaching all this thing in detail, but at least I have explained, so that when I say like in the eye we have got convex lens, it is converging, so we will be able to understand, oh yeah, in eye we have got such kind of lens, our lens is like this. When I will be discussing about the diseases myopia and hypermetropia, and when we will be talking about the disease, you know, the lenses that where the image formation takes place and which kind of lens do we use, then we will need this background, like yeah, this kind of lenses make this kind of image, and that is the reason I am discussing lens all, you know, even though it is not there in the portion, rather it is there in the 7th standard. So this all should be very clear in the 7th standard, but in 8th, to understand eyes, if you have not understood in 7th, this very basic things, you know, very basic things I am explaining. I know when you talk about the 10th standard, these all are related to 10th standard, but this all are not at all enough for 10th standard, right. So here first rule I have discussed just superficially, that a ray which is parallel to the principal axis will pass through the focus. Now the second rule, right, this is again the lens and this is the optical center, right. Now when this, you know, this is C, now this is the principal axis, right, this is the principal axis X and Y, right. Now when the ray of light, right, when the ray of light passes through the optical center, when the ray of light which passes through the optical center, it will not deviate and it will pass straight away like this only, right. So this is a ray of light A and B which is passing through this optical center, so this is passing like this and it will not deviate and it will pass, it will trace the same path and it will move back with the same path. So this is a second rule, again I am talking about the second rule. This is a convex lens, this is a principal axis XY, this center point is known as optical center. Now when the ray of light which passes through this optical center, I told you while discussing the optical center, this has got one, you know, characteristic feature that when the ray of light passes through the optical center, it do not deviate. It do not deviate, and so it will not deviate and it will pass as it is taking the same path. You know, children, actually, whenever we talk about any kind of image formation, we always keep the object at the principal axis. Then we talk about the two rays. The rays which we take comes from the top of this object. This thought may come in mind, like, why we are not talking about the ray which comes out from this bottom point, right? This bottom point. So let me make it very clear. From here, if we take the ray which is coming, passing from this point, again it will take the same path. Even in the mirrors, when the ray fall perpendicularly to the to the reflecting surface, it will take the same path. It will come back following the same path. But at the principal axis, we do not put the arrows. Are you getting my point? On the principal axis, always we consider, where do we consider the object? Where do we keep the object? We always keep the object on the principal axis. Now, when the object is kept at the principal axis, and when we talk about the ray diagrams, we always talk like, yeah, ray is coming from the top of this arrow or the object. Why don't we consider that the arrow, why don't we consider that the light ray is coming from this bottom of this object? We do not consider this because when the light ray is coming from this, because it is perpendicular, it is to the principal axis, so it will come back following the same path. It will go like this, and again it will come back following the same path, right? Okay, so this was our rule number second. Now we'll talk about the rule number third. Here I should make, I'll make here. Okay, here this one is a nice space. So this is my third rule. Now this is the optical center, right? And x and y. Now when the ray of light, right, when the ray of light, it comes from the focus, right? When the ray of light, now this is the focus, when the ray of light comes from the focus, right, it becomes, when the, this is focus f dash, when the ray of light passes through the focus, after refraction from the lens, it becomes parallel to the principal axis, right? So you may consider this A, B, this is D, and this one is E, right? So this is my convex lens, this is the O, which is optical center, this is principal axis XY, a ray of light, okay, which passes from the focus, a ray of light which passes from the focus after refraction through the lens, after refraction through the lens becomes parallel to the principal axis, right? So these are the three laws, rules when we talk about the convex lens, and this has to be kept in mind because now we will be discussing about the image formation. So when we discuss about the image formation, these rules are very, very important, and we need to know these rules. Until unless we know these rules, we won't be able to make the images, the ray diagrams, right? So now we'll talk about the image formation in the convex mirror lenses. We'll talk about the image formation in the convex lenses. So now we'll talk about the rules of the image formation in the convex lens, right? Rules of the image formation in the convex lens, right? So now what we are studying, we will be studying, we'll be discussing rules which are required to understand the image formation in the convex lenses. Now we have studied till now the plane mirrors, concave mirrors, and the convex mirrors. Now we know at least the rules, some or more or less, they're all a little bit similar. At least the terminologies are similar, right? So the first rule says, now before this I'll draw this. This is the lens, convex lens, this is the optical center, and this is the principal axis XY, right? This is optical center O. So when a ray of light which is parallel, right, a ray of light which is parallel, say this is AB, which is a parallel ray to the principal axis, after refraction, okay, after refraction through lens, you know, it passes through the focus. It passes through the focus. So what does the first rule says? A parallel ray. Okay, what does the first rule says? A parallel ray to principal axis passes through focus after refraction. Right? It passes through it passes through focus after refraction. This is the first rule. Now, what does the second rule says? The second rule says, now this is the lens, this is the principal axis, this is optical center, right? Now, if you remember, just before few minutes we have discussed, like when the ray of light passes through the optical center, it do not deviate, it just passes straight. So a ray of light which passes through this optical center, it just, see, this is a ray of light AB which is passing through this optical center. I need to put arrow like this because it is moving in this way, so it is not getting deviated, okay, it is not getting, not going anywhere, it just passes from this point, right? So what does the second law says? A ray of light passing through the passing through optical center do not deviate and just pass straight from following this path, right? This is the second rule. Now what does the third rule says, children? The third rule says, now this is the lens, right? This is the optical center. Now this is the principal axis. Now the third rule says that when a ray of light which passes through the focus, right, which passes through the focus, becomes parallel after refraction. Okay, now again AB or B here, anything, you can change this, this is O, this is D, it will go like this, right? So here also one arrow I can put. So this is the third law. What does it say, children? It says that when the ray of light which passes through the focus, right, which passes through the focus, it will, you know, become parallel after refraction, right? Now see, in these images, these rules also, there are certain more things, you know, which need to be explained, but again up to this level these many things are sufficient to understand. So third rule says, like a ray of light passing through focus or coming through focus coming through focus passes through a ray of light coming through focus not passes becomes parallel to the principal axis becomes parallel to the principal axis after refraction. Here these all rules, whatever we are discussing, is all about convex lens, right? So what are the three rules which we have discussed? for the convex lenses. The first one, that see, first of all, this is the lens, this is optical center, this is principal axis in all the diagrams. This is O, can be represented by C also. Now this is the principal axis represented by X and Y. Now ray of light which is parallel to this principal axis will pass through focus after refraction, first rule. Second rule, when a ray of light which passes through optical center, it do not get deviated, it just pass straight, you know, it do not get deviated. Third, when a ray of light comes from the focus, then after refraction it becomes parallel to the principal axis, right? So these are the three important rules which we need to keep it in our mind when we go for the image formation, because for the image formation these rules are required, and without knowing and understanding these rules we won't be able to draw the you know, ray diagrams of anything, you know, we talk about the convex, anything, whatever. So here we have discussed about the convex lens rules, so we need to have these things in our mind so that we can go with the images very, very properly. So now we'll talk about the images in the convex lenses. So now we'll you know, keep the object at different places on the principal axis, and we'll see, observe like how the image formation takes place, where does the image formation takes place, which kind of image does, you know, which kind of image is formed, and what is the use of that image, and what is the use of knowing that where the object has to be kept in, which kind of image will be formed. So first thing, first image, first of all we are talking about convex lens, okay, so we are talking about images in convex lenses. Now the first is when we keep the object, okay, when we keep the object between the optical center and the focus. Okay, I have not written between here, so this is between. So we have to keep the object between the optical center and the focus, between the optical center and the focus. So now this is my lens, definitely. Now principal axis X and Y, this is my optical center O. Now this is my F dash, this is my F, right? Now what I have done, I have to keep the object between the optical center, this is optical center and this is F dash focus. So I have to keep object somewhere between over here, right? So I'll keep the object here. Now we will discuss, we will draw only two lines to make the diagram, to keep the diagram simpler, to understand the diagram in a very nice, in a proper way, right? To reduce the complications, first thing. And the second thing is, you know, we will see, we will follow the rules also in this, okay? We will, you know, like we have to see how we can fit the rules over here. Now first of all, the ray, we'll consider first of all the ray which is coming from the head, arrowhead, right, the top of the object. Now a ray of light is coming, let's say A, B, it's coming here, it is parallel, AB is parallel to the principal axis, and so it is going to pass through the focus. So it will be passing through the focus, it will pass through the focus, it has passed through the focus. Now second line, second ray which will take, will be coming from the top only, and it passes, you know, through the optical center, right, it passes through the optical center and it will not deviate. Now just try to understand, this is AB and this is AD, you imagine, after refraction over here it becomes as E and F. So just see, the person who is seeing from here, you know, will not be able to see these rays as here. Like first of all, again we'll take, this is the lens, this is the optical center, this is the principal axis, this is F, this is F dash. Now we have, where we have to keep the object, we have to keep the object between the optical center, this optical center and the focus, right? So we have kept the object over here. Now the first ray which is coming from the top of the this object, it is parallel to the principal axis, and so it passes through the focus. Second ray, it is passing through this optical center and it will go straight only without deviating. But you can find these two rays are diverging rays, isn't it? These two rays are diverging rays. So actually, you know, actually, these two rays will not intersect at any point. Until unless the intersection of the rays won't take place, the image formation will not take place. You know, which kind of image? The real image. Now, what has to be done? As we know, these two rays will never meet. So what has to be done? These rays will extend it towards a back. Right, so what we'll do, these rays will extend back this one, and we have find one, you know, and we have find one point over here, right, we have find one point over here, and we can name it as A dash, as this is A and, okay, B we have already taken over here. So I will take as A, G, right? This is the object, right? Actually, AB should be taken, but we have already taken B over here. So now, this one point we have got, this one point is the image of this point, right? If we draw perpendicular over here, I will get the total, you know, images of all the points, AG dash. Now, this is the image of this object, right? Now, you can see which kind of image is formed and where it is formed, children. This is the first case where we are talking about the convex lens. This is the first case where we have kept the object between the optical center and the focus. When we keep the object between the optical center and the focus, first ray which we are considering to come from the top of the object, that means from that arrow-headed object, first ray, as it is parallel to this principal axis, it will pass from focus, isn't it? It will pass from focus. And second, as we have to pass it from optical center, it will come from the optical center, it will not deviate and come out as it is. Now these two are diverging, they are diverging, they are going separated, so they won't meet. So what has to be done? We extend these two rays at the back side and we get a point A dash. Now this is A point, A dash point, which is the image of this point A. Now if we draw perpendicular from A dash to the principal axis, we will get the images of all the points. This is A dash, G, G dash image of the AG object, right? Now, which kind of image is formed, children? The image is behind the object. It is behind the object. Second, it is not formed, it cannot be formed on the screen, as the rays are not intersecting in, you know, they are not intersecting actually. So virtual image is formed. We all know virtual images are always erect image. So virtual and erect image is formed, and we all can see it is larger, so the larger image is formed, or enlarged image, whatever you want to enlarge images form. So this is the first case. Now we'll move to the second case, right? So we are talking about the convex lens here, the image formation we are talking about. Now we have discussed first, now we'll be talking about the second position.